We're saying is that okay, it's really hard to translate. Wait a minute, I gotta hear that again. Okay, saying the government's crazy, basically. Translate to English, it pretty much means, yeah, the government's crazy, and they're chanting that over and over again. Okay, well, like I said, I am low on battery, but I'll try to record more of this as I can for you. Okay, so we have people on this side who are basically like on government property. And again, like I said, we have another group of people. We're on the other side where I came from across the street there who are participating but not actively. And that's where the majority of the police are at. We have another Lawrence Line police going in the direction you see there where the officers are at. Okay, you see a lot of signs, things like that. Of interest here, you'll find to be extremely surprising that just as this past weekend, as the oil reactors were approved for restart, as soon as they attempted to restart the oil reactors, there was an incident for a lack of water in one of the cooling pools at the oil reactors. So that only fueled the people's anger and frustration over the government and the behavior of the nuclear industry in general in Japan, that they can't even do the things they say they're going to do. They guarantee these people safety at the reactors, yet safety is exactly what they don't get. So I think all of you can appreciate these people's anger with the situation here in Japan currently. It's actually a bit amazing to be here to see this right now and to be right in the middle of this. It's kind of breathtaking and awe-inspiring. Okay, you see they're starting to march. There's a girl across the street. I'm hearing the flags and banners now. Okay, I'll try to get over there for you. Are trying to maintain control. All right. All right, look, we're seeing a slight bit of civil disobedience, but nothing too severe. All right. Playing traffic through again. I don't know when the police gonna break this up, but it appears the police are starting to communicate and starting to do something at the moment. All right, I'm gonna move over here a bit. As you can see, people are moving around a little bit here. All right. Pardon me if I'm shaking the camera a little bit. It just it's a little nerve-wracking. So even you. There are some young kids also protesting here today. Okay, we're in a very crowded. All right, you can see that we have just the average Japanese person as well as here. It's not just people are heavily involved in nuclear, anti-nuclear movement, but just the average Japanese is coming out. All right. All right, so we're kind of real crowded at the moment, so we have to... You see, there's the row of police I just came from on the other side. All right, you see that? I'm trying to get over people's heads. Yeah, I'm short too. I apologize. Okay. Uh-oh. Okay, I'm gonna move over here just a little bit. Let me show you that. It's just a cross section of people, young, old, businessmen, college students, housewives. Everybody's out here. Those, you know, protest organizers are here. It's really amazing. See just how many different types of people are here. So, for everyone who thinks that the Japanese are not fighting, you're wrong. They are fighting. But the thing is, they can't do this by themselves. And they're gonna need help. And sadly, the world's not paying attention to these people. It appears, you know, that we have movements like Anonymous and Occupy and different, all these groups like that, just not really paying attention to this. So kind of glad we're able to get footage of this just to show you that they are fighting and they are willing to stand up against what their government's trying to do. Now, I just need to reiterate again, this is rather unprecedented. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and finish this up. I'm running really long right now. All right, so everyone, this is me, Ryan, here in downtown Tokyo in the middle of a massive protest. Until next time, guys, I'm out, okay?